Can it be true? A metal body? Yes, this is the Samsung Galaxy Alpha, and it's been a long time coming. While Samsung's built its reputation on producing very capable, powerful, high-end smartphones, until this point they've lagged behind their rivals in one key area, materials. The Alpha is the first device hoping to change all that, with its standout feature being this high-precision milled aluminium frame. Despite sporting the same size display as Apple's iPhone 6, the Alpha's bodywork gives it smaller proportions all round, not to mention it feels impeccably light at just 115 grams. The metal bodywork takes the feel of this Samsung up a gear, above the likes of even the S5. Aesthetically, it's more distinctive than any previous Galaxies too, and those straight edges remind us of Apple's long-praised iPhone 5 and 5S. The hardware controls along the sides are small but perfectly crafted, and as a result, the phone is a joy to pick up and play with. Despite the love, there is one inescapable Samsung trait that rears its head on the Alpha: the bendy, removable plastic back. And whilst we appreciate the ability to swap out the phone's 1860mAh battery, and the fact it provides excellent levels of grip, it just cheapens the overall feel of the device unnecessarily. One other glaring omission for what is one of Samsung's top handsets is the lack of waterproofing. Having been spoiled by the IP certification enjoyed by the S5, we were surprised to learn that the Alpha loses this ability altogether. The Alpha's dimensions are governed by its 4.7-inch 720p HD Super AMOLED display. The choice of AMOLED ensures wonderfully deep blacks, a good level of contrast, and in this instance a strong backlight when you're maxing out the brightness in sunlight, not to mention some seriously vivid colours. Its white aren't as brilliant as on rival LCD panels, and the oversaturated look won't be to everybody's tastes. Samsung's latest touch of skin features some tweaked visual elements that give it a cleaner overall feel on the Alpha. Iconography is flatter, and many of the native widgets adopt greater levels of transparency, so you can better enjoy your wallpaper, for example. Samsung has also packed the Alpha with a wealth of pre-installed services like My Magazine, a skinned flipboard-powered newsfeed not unlike HTC's Blink feed, and health nuts will appreciate the fitness tracking capabilities of the Alpha, which tie into the heart rate sensor mounted on the phone's back. Great for keeping tabs on your steps from the lock screen, specific exercise tracking, and thanks to the ability to install additional fitness components through S-Health, the option to download full workouts. At the heart of the Alpha lies the company's own Exynos octa-core processor. Somewhat of a stranger when we're used to Qualcomm-powered alternatives, but in practice this chipset twinned with 2GB of RAM and that modest 720p HD resolution ensures buttery smooth operation whatever the task. Despite the phone's price, the removable back only gives you access to that 2-day battery. For some reason, Samsung didn't instill the Alpha with expandable storage like practically every other handset it offers, and we're really not sure why. Another piece of design that lives a double life is the home button. As with the S5, swiping your finger over it can be used as a password substitute, letting you unlock the device, or commit to a PayPal purchase. It's a lot more hit and miss than Apple's Touch ID sensor, but it's convenient nonetheless. If you're a sucker for selfies, you'll appreciate the phone's always-on beauty mode. Simply by switching to the front-facing 2.1MP camera, you can dial up or down the level of beautification your face undergoes. Around the back, the 12MP camera's automatic shooting mode can cover most situations, and the insanely bright LED flash does a good job of capturing subjects in poorly lit conditions too. Detail isn't the highest around, but it's more than usable for social butterflies looking to share their latest outfit, meal, or kitten pic. On the video front, there are a number of options, including fast and slow motion video capture and UHD shooting too, making this one of the smallest phones able to film in 4K. Whilst there are certainly problems with the Alpha, it's a sort of sidestep in the right direction for Samsung, a well-balanced performance smartphone that serves as another fantastic Android alternative to Apple's iPhone 6, alongside the likes of the Sony Xperia Z3 Compact. Some might balk at the £539 SIM-free price tag, and that's understandable, but this handset doesn't go bigger for the sake of it. It focuses more on delivering quality and consistency that's hard to fault, and we commend Samsung for that. We're going to show you how to move your music over from iTunes, which is the typical program you'd sync your content with on an iPhone, to the Samsung Galaxy S3. Now it all starts.
Overall, it feels a bit more streamlined, although the flipboard-style magazine UI is basically just a rehashed Blink feed. And how better to enjoy the new touch.
Tip number 3, setting a smarter screen. This phone's full HD screen isn't just pretty, it's smart too. Smart Stay was a feature on last year's Galaxy.